I want to tell you a story about a god of the Northmen called Baldur. The second son of Odin. He was beautiful, good, and wise. He was fair of feature, he spoke fair words, he gave fair judgments. Light shone from him. Only good things were told of him. Yet he was the first of the gods to die.
Okay, this is different than last time. I guess we have to do all these one by one.
You can. You need the runes to fight Dillian. You need Dillian. He's waiting for you. He always said he would. He's close. He cares about you. He's close. He loves you.
The Northmen tell this story about the death of Baldur. It begins with dark dreams. Night after night, Baldur dreams of his own death, and the gods fear for his life. So Baldur's mother makes everything in the world. Fire, water, iron, stone, earth, wood, beasts, birds, serpents, poison, sickness. Swear an oath not to harm her sons. One by one, they each make their vow. Neither weapons nor wood will injure him, Baldur's mother boasts. Only Loki, father of Hela, the mistress of death, is not amused.
So where's this thing? The other side of that bridge, maybe? Can we even go down there? Yes, we can. Does it mean I'm close or not? Hi, Addy. Trying to find a symbol. It should be near here somewhere, but... Wait, I think I might know how to get there. Using the means at my disposal. But I need to figure out how to get in here through the dark.
The world once seemed so simple. Black and white. Darkness and light. Narrow dividing lines of our own making. Dillian taught her to see further. To peek through the cracks and see the worlds of color stretching away from the gloom. And Senno explored new paths into the unknown.
The gods feast and rejoice and amuse themselves by throwing spears and stones at Balder, striking at him with sword and axe. But he comes to no harm, whatever they do. The gods never cease to wonder at this great marvel. But Loki shapes himself into a woman and asks Balder's mother, "Is it really true that all things promise to keep him safe?" "I did not ask the mistletoe," Balder's mother confesses. "I thought it was too young."
"Dillian's in the tower."
"Oh dear."
"He's there."
So yes, welcome to Hellblade. A journey into the mind of a Celtic warrior suffering from psychosis.
"Not in this world."
Thank you. wish I had a better headset.
He didn't know she listened to me. She thought she could do it.
Just to get the full brunt of the pretty great audio design on this.
There he is.
Where are you taking him?
He's up there. How do you get up there? There's a way. There is a way up there.
Find the way.
She can do this. You're nearly there. Shh. Find the way.
The blind god. Hoth was there. Loki asks him why he wasn't taking part. Hoth says, I cannot see where Baldur stands, and even if I could see him, I have no weapon. Loki replies, here is a wand. I will tell you where he stands. And Hoth throws the mistletoe at Baldur. It pierces through him, and to everyone's horror, Baldur is killed. And for this, Hood is slain.
Nobody will love her now.
Can you remember what love feels like?
Look what happens to the thing she loves.
She destroys the one she loves.
The Northmen tell how the gods mourned Baldur. His body was to be burnt on his ship, but they could not manage to push it into the sea and sent for a giantess to do it. She comes riding a wolf and has vipers for her reins. She pushes Baldur's ship.
Years had passed since she left her father. She trained hard alongside her friend, Dillian. She saw things no one else could. Patterns. Shapes, movement, an intuition that made her an exceptional warrior. Friendship turned to love. But the shadow of darkness never let her go, and she was caught between two worlds. That of Zinbel and her past, and Dillian, her future. Two realities. Dillian saved her. You owe your life to Dillian. You owe everything to him.
Doesn't help that the entire room is lit up. I knew I might be able to see shapes. But
Dillian cared for her like no one else has. Dillian's the only reason she's still alive. What if they're all about wasting your time? Just delay minute by minute by minute.
She's alive at all.
Dillian's the only reason she's still alive. Overcome with grief, the gods send Hermod to ride to Hel and ask Hela to let Baldur return home. All the gods are weeping, he says. Are they? Asks Hela. We shall see if he is truly missed. If everything in the world will weep for him, he shall go back to the gods. But if even one thing refuses, Baldur stays with me. The gods send messengers everywhere. Weep for Baldur. Weep him out of hell. And everything wept. Men, beasts, earth, stone, trees, metal, everything. Except for a giantess they find in a cave. Baldur was never my friend, she says. Let Hel keep what she has.
Okay, so how do we get here?
Dillion didn't believe in the curse. Dillion believed in you.
How do I get over there? Clearly not use that from this distance.
Dillion saved you from them.
Mm-hmm.
He's the reason she keeps fighting.
Go down here and it's sunlight.
Do you remember meeting him beneath the tree?
No, it's locked.
You won't think you can be. We couldn't see the darkness within you. Your love because he believed in you. Tried that sooner. Do you remember the way he looked? You have no chance.
Oh, stop it. Probably should look when I walk. At least nice and straightforward.
She thought she had to have no time for this. Speed up.
So that didn't fix anything. But I can probably take the bar off the door on the other side if I go back to the sunlight. Probably tried that first. We'll get there slowly, one creepy whisper at a time.
He was the only one she could trust. Could she trust him? Do you remember how he made you feel?
We are, finally.
You kill the things you love with your curse. You kill the things that are is pointless. What are you doing? Why did you think you could make this work? You keep seeing runes. You see runes everywhere. Everywhere. But what if they're not real? What if they don't actually make sense? The gods were lying. Do you think it makes sense? Really, the gods are playing with you. It makes sense in your mind.
Dillian never much cared for the underworld, and looked dimly upon the druids, like her father, Zinbal. I guess he took after his father, a chieftain who believed nothing he couldn't see, and he happened to be blind. She felt safe in Dillian's arms, learned to see the world through his eyes. Slowly, the darkness that had bound her so tightly began to unravel.
Go to him. That's it.
Quicker.
Girl.
Quicker.
Shinua, your father cannot understand your darkness. He cannot see through your eyes. No one can. My own father was born blind. Doesn't have the faintest idea of what the night looks like. The word dark to him means as little as the word light. So someone is afraid of the dark. Should we fix them by taking away their sight? Would you give up the beautiful world that you, and only you, can see just to be rid of your nightmares? Or is this the price
you pay? What if this is pointless? What if you're wrong? What if we're wrong? The sword will never be
gifted. She's so special in my...
What if this is the end?
It's just a trick.
It's just a pointless test. You've been fooled before. You could be fooled again.
You're being tested. I need to
It's just that game for you. You never know which way it's going to go.
But it made it worse. I'm so sorry.